Brain zaps and antidepressants. Why do they happen? How long do they last? What do you do about them? That's what I'm going to be talking about today. I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I publish weekly videos on mental health education and self-improvement. If you do not want to miss one, click subscribe and the notification button so you are notified when a new video comes out. Brain zaps are part of what we call medication discontinuation syndrome. Medication discontinuation syndrome are symptoms that you can see when you suddenly stop taking your medication or if your dose suddenly drops from high to low, for example, when there's drastic changes in the medication level in your bloodstream. In this case, I'm going to be talking about what you see when you stop the serotonin-enhancing antidepressants. So first, let me talk about the symptoms. An easy way to remember these symptoms is with the mnemonic finish. F stands for flu-like symptoms, and this can be things like achiness, sweating, headache, fatigue. You can really feel like you're coming down with the flu. I stands for insomnia. If you suddenly stop your medication, you can have trouble sleeping and even have vivid dreams. I have a video I made several years ago on why antidepressants cause vivid dreams. You'll see that in the corner. And you can watch it after the video. But in this case, the vivid dreams would be occurring as a part of the discontinuation syndrome. N stands for nausea or maybe even vomiting. I is for imbalance or dizziness or even vertigo, which is when you feel like your head is spinning. S is for sensory disturbances, and this would be the electric shocks that seem like they're coming from your brain. Some people call them brain zaps, and it's kind of like someone is suddenly turning on an electrical source on and off in your head, or kind of like a glitch. Some people even describe it as though your brain is dropping in space, all kind of weird sensations having to do with your brain. But you can also have burning or tingling sensations in your body as well. And then lastly, H stands for hyperarousal, and this would be anxiety, irritability, aggression, or even jerkiness. Any of these symptoms can occur when you stop the medication suddenly. And this isn't that hard to do. You can go on vacation, leave your pills at home, or you can take your last pill in the morning and then you forgot to call the pharmacy. Then the pharmacy has to order it or your insurance has to approve it. I mean, and that can take a couple days. So it's not always intentional that someone just stops taking their medication. Now, you may say, I've missed a pill or two here and there, and this didn't happen to me. It's more likely to happen with medications that have a short half-life. Half-life is the amount of time that it takes for the drug to break down to half the amount. And drugs with short half-lives leave your body quicker than ones with long half-lives. And some examples of shorter-acting antidepressants that you can see this with are Paxil, Effexor, and Cymbalta. Why does this happen? Well, of course, we don't know exactly why it happens because we don't look in people's brains to see what's going on at the time that it's happening. But a working theory is that it has to do with the sudden depletion of serotonin and norepinephrine in the nerve cells. So when you strip the drug away, you get this rebound effect that makes the nerve hyperactive. This hyperactivity of the norepinephrine in your brain is thought to be causing this shock-like feeling. Now, this is just a theory, but it is a real thing that happens to people. So when does it happen? The symptoms of discontinuation syndrome, including all of the ones that I mentioned, not just the brain shocks, but the flu-like symptoms and the other things, can show up within a day to 3 or 4 days, and they can last from a day or even about 2 weeks on average. Some people have reported the symptoms though lasting a year. And I've seen some patients where it lasted longer than 2 weeks, but it wasn't happening every single day. It may have started out every single day, but after a couple weeks, it just kind of tapered off. But then there may be a day here and there where it popped up again. And that kind of went on for a few months. So what do we do about it? Well, the first and obvious thing is that you should always wean off your medicine and not to stop it suddenly. But hey, if you go on vacation and leave your medication behind, or if you're going on a long work trip or something, you may just want to go through the trouble of getting a temporary supply of it called into a pharmacy wherever you are. But if you, let's say you can't do that, and or you're only gone a few days. Once you get back home, if you restart the medication, the symptoms usually go away within a day or so. What if you were trying to get off the medicine anyway and you don't really want to get back on it? Then you would consult with your doctor about restarting the medication, but gradually tapering off of it. And depending on how long you were taking it and the dose that you were taking, you may want to taper over a couple of months. A slow taper would be reducing the dose every couple of weeks to a month. A faster taper would be reducing the dose every few days. Effexor and Cymbalta can be pretty wicked when it comes to this kind of withdrawal, so you wouldn't want to go too rapid with these medications. And tapering your medication should be something you do with your doctor's assistance so that you know exactly how much to reduce your dose by and how often you should reduce it. How do you know when your taper is complete? The general rule is that the dose that you started at is usually the dose at which you can stop. So for example, we usually start Cymbalta at 30 milligrams. So once you get down to 30 milligrams, you can usually stop at that dose. But what if you have trouble getting off that last 30 milligrams? There is a 20 milligram dose of Cymbalta, but that's not really the point, because if you have trouble getting off at 30, you're probably going to have trouble getting off at 20. A workaround to this is that we will sometimes add another medication like Prozac. Now, hold on, you might say, well, why would I start a new medication when I'm trying to get off this first one? Adding Prozac would be a temporary thing to help you get off the Cymbalta, because Prozac is a long-acting antidepressant. In fact, it takes about a month to completely get out of your system. Short-acting medications tend to have a sharp drop-off when they wear off, whereas longer-acting medications tend to have a smoother on and a smoother off. Since the withdrawal has to do with your body getting used to the medication being gone, when you add Prozac, you add back a little bit of the serotonin and then let it gradually fall off because of the long half-life. Now, that said, discontinuation syndrome rarely happens with Prozac, especially at lower doses. One last point about this. It's important to realize that the symptoms that you can get when you suddenly or quickly stop your antidepressant is a withdrawal effect. This is different from a relapse. I bring this up because sometimes people will feel as though they can never get off their medication because every time they try to get off, they start to feel worse. Now, it could be that you're stopping the medication while you're in the throes of an episode and now is not the time. But real relapse symptoms don't come on as quickly as a day or two. You usually see this with withdrawal or discontinuation. If you're wanting to see whether or not you'll be okay off of medication, you really need to give it a month or two to see how you feel and whether or not you'll be fine without taking the medication. I hope this was helpful. I'm interested to know if you've had this experience with stopping a medication. And if you know someone who could benefit from this video, then share it. See you next week.